When I started studying meteorology, of course, my mom was extremely pleased with my choice. Not because she thought I would one day be a scientist in Australia. She wanted me to be a TV presenter, a meteorologist on TV, and she would see me every night explaining the weather on TV. That was her dream. That was her dream job for me. I grew up in a little town called Dessau, which is about 130 kilometers south of Berlin in Germany, and it belonged to the former East Germany. I wasn't a collector of things. I was also not a what they call a weather weenie, a person who goes out and looks at the weather and measures temperature and writes it down every day. I didn't come to what I do now through this sort of connection with, oh, I wonder how the weather works. I was more, came to it more from, I'd like to do math on something useful.
Well, that's very different.
Climate science isn't one science. It's many things brought together to look at the Earth. We have people who know about plants. We have people like me who know about clouds. We have people who know about the deep ocean and how the water circulates in the deep ocean. So when we all meet, there isn't the same language, but that's part of the fun. I worked at this place called the European Center for Medium Range Weather Forecasts, and it's a big weather prediction center that has a big model. It's the best model in the world. It has been since its existence in the 80s. It still is today. And I worked on their model and I changed things in that model. And these things then become part of the model that makes the forecast every day. And in some sense, that's more than I ever hoped to achieve. And for 8 years, I was sitting in England in front of a computer screen. I had never seen a tropical cloud in my life. I had never been to the tropics. And there I was, modeling them. And one of the reasons I came to Australia was actually to see what I've been modeling. The tropics is kind of the engine room of the climate system. And so it's a very exciting place to study. Climate change has, in my view, two components to it. One is relatively simple, and that is that if we add CO2 to the atmosphere, the planet will warm, and there are some simple processes that govern that. We don't quite know by how much, but we know if you double CO2, it's somewhere between 2 and 4.5 degrees, somewhere in that range. We are not necessarily far away from that large change in temperature. How that then translates into changes in Melbourne, Berlin, Dessau, wherever people are interested in knowing what's going to happen, that's a much more difficult question to answer. And I think some of the debate comes from not understanding the subtle differentiation between the easy part and the more difficult part. Climate science, because it's so politicized, people try and use the uncertainty to say, oh, if it's that uncertain, we can't make any decisions. We need more certainty before we can do anything. And I think it's completely untrue. A lot can be done now.